one of our patients at the Kasese Adolescent Center, his name, we'll call him Timmy. He was HIV positive and 13 years old at the time. He was an orphan, so he ended up in Kasese, Uganda, which is where our project is located. And he was relocated there to live with another family. And that's where we came into play and met him. In terms of how we measure how sick a child is with HIV, we use a CD4 count, which is basically the number of white blood cells a person has. And it's good to have 500 or more. Timmy had 13. He was very sick. It is important to test the other brothers in the family. When we did so, it turned out that one of the brothers also was HIV positive. When that happened, Timmy was blamed for giving the other boy HIV. The family started treating him a little bit badly. He wasn't getting the nutrition that he needed, the rest that he needed, or the medication that he needed. And he was getting sicker, and we actually made a move to relocate him to an orphanage in the area who also had expertise in working with HIV clients. When we told Timmy that he was leaving and we found him another place to live, he was grinning ear to ear because he felt like he was going into a safe environment. MSF focused on HIV care to adolescents in Kasese because they're the most vulnerable group. Adolescents in general are a very special group in terms of how you provide treatment and care to them, especially around confidentiality issues. So what MSF did was make a pure adolescent center where they have games, and also we would teach health talks to them twice a day. We would have over 200 adolescents visiting the recreation side of the center on weekends. And a large portion of the adolescents that actually went in to be tested for HIV came to be tested because they first would access the center and come and play games and get used to the staff there. And then they would come over for their HIV testing. One of the most important and effective ways to work with adolescents with HIV is in the group setting. They're in that adolescent developmental stage where they count really heavily on their peers, and they felt included, they felt normal, they felt part of a community and had that support from each other. Many of the adults in their life, they're embarrassed and they stigmatize their own children about having HIV. So we really work heavily with the parents to help them understand also about stigma and also about the disease process and the importance of medication, being on a regimen that's steady, and also good nutrition, sleep, rest, and all of those kinds of things. So the family is a very important piece. And we saw that again in Timmy's case, where we really needed the family to be on board and do certain steps, and they were unable to do that.